Okay, what'll happen if you pour some water on your phone lens? How can you make a new phone case in 10 seconds? And why you should start collecting popsicle sticks right now? Sounds crazy, right? But hey, that's what we do here. Follow me. Inflate a balloon so that it's just large enough to fit your phone. Put the gadget in the center of the balloon and let the air out. Congrats! You just got yourself a new phone case. A plastic bottle can serve as the most basic tripod for your phone. Just attach the gadget to the bottle with a rubber band. Make a wrist holder for your phone out of an old watch band. Fasten the strap and fix it to a phone case with super glue. The negative end of a regular battery works as an excellent stylus. You can make a unique pop socket out of a dresser knob. Just attach it to your phone case with some super glue. A plastic bottle can also provide you with a pop socket material. Remove its top section. It should be the size of your future accessory. Mark the outlines of its widest part on a piece of paper or cardboard. Decorate this piece with a nice pattern, stickers, beads, or whatever you like. Glue it on top of the bottle section. Then glue the bottle cap to your phone case. Use an empty plastic mint box for keeping your headphones. Make a small hole in the bottom and pull the cord through it. No more tangling. Make an office desk phone stand out of two binder clips. Fold one of the clips to look like a chair. After that, attach the other clip to the first one's end. A simple eraser will help you clean the phone screen, your earphones, and all the phone cords. A lint roller is perfect for cleaning your phone speakers. Roll it over the speakers and it'll take out all the dust. Attach a clip to a book holder, add some stickers or paint it with nail polish, and you'll get a cute photo frame and phone stand rolled into one. You can make your phone camera photos unique with half-transparent paper. Hold it next to the edge of the lens. Try several colors for a rainbow effect. Hold a white sheet of paper next to your model while taking their portrait photo to make the colors smoother, or use it as a backdrop for your flat lays. If you want to take a picture from above, attach your phone to the ceiling with some tape and activate the shutter remotely. For a dramatic pinhole effect, make a hole in a piece of cardboard and hold it in front of your photo camera lens. Try changing the distance to the lens or hole sizes. Experiment with plants. They can cast some beautiful shades on your model. Turn your phone lens into a macro lens with a simple drop of water. It'll help you take super detailed close-ups. Use your phone's friend to get a cool mirror effect in the photo. Hold the second phone horizontally and line it up with the lower edge of your phone's lens. Tilt it to find the right angle, and the screen of the second phone will reflect an image into your picture. Boost your phone speakers with paper cups and a toilet paper roll. Ah, toilet paper, I remember that. Mark the bottom outline of your phone on the roll. If your phone is too wide for this, use a kitchen roll tube instead. Make a slot where you'll later put your phone. Mark each end of the roll on horizontally placed cups and carve two holes. Decorate the cups and roll with some tape or paint and slot the roll into the cups. Another use for a toilet paper roll is a phone stand. Flatten the roll and draw the outlines of your future holder. Don't forget to make two little pockets to keep your phone in place. Get creative and decorate the stand any way you like. Customize a plain phone case with colorful buttons. First, arrange the buttons around the case without using glue to see how they fit. Then, cover the top quarter of the case with super glue and stick the buttons to it. Continue to add glue and buttons section by section. When you're done, let the whole thing dry for 24 hours. Not to drop your phone while running, put your phone case inside your sleeve and insert your gadget in its case from the outer side. You can build a cool phone holder from popsicle sticks. Yeah! Glue four sticks together, one on top of another. Connect three more in the same way. Take two more sticks and glue them in the shape of the capital letter A. Let them dry, then attach the first four-stick piece on top. Turn the construction and glue the remaining 3-stick piece on the back. Break another popsicle stick in half and attach it to support the stand. Create a galaxy on the back of your phone. A dark colored case will look more epic. Pick 3 or more nail polish shades. Cut a makeup sponge into several pieces and randomly dab different colors on the phone case. Paint some stars with the help of white polish and a toothpick and add glitter. Cover it all with 2 layers of transparent polish and let it dry well. You can use your iPhone as a mini scanner. Create a note, tap the camera button, and choose Scan Documents. Line up the paper and tap the shutter. Do it as many times as needed to save several pages in one file. To sign a file or add some other marks, open the note with a scan in it. Tap the Share button, choose Markup, and press the plus button. Pick between text, signature, magnifier, or shape. After you're finished, don't forget to tap Done and save the changes. Build a projector for your phone from a shoebox and a magnifying glass. Draw the outlines of the lens on the side of the box. Cut a hole and attach the magnifying glass to the box with super glue. Put a phone stand made of 2 pieces of cardboard inside the box. Attach your phone to the stand with double-sided tape. Set the device to maximum brightness, lock the screen, and get it focused. Make a holder for charging your phone from an old lotion bottle. Draw a line where you want to have the front of the holder. Then turn the bottle around and draw a higher back. Remember to cut a hole for the charger to go through. Use sandpaper to make the surface smooth and hide the lettering on the bottle. Mod Podge some pretty fabric onto it, and don't forget to stick a small oval piece to the bottom. Create fake twins with the help of panorama mode. Position your model on the left side of the photo. Start slowly moving the camera along the center line. Meanwhile, the person must run out of the picture and move to the right behind your back. This way, the camera catches them again. Keep going until you get enough twins in the picture. To take a perfectly level top-down photo, use the built-in camera level feature on your iPhone. Point the camera straight at an object and slightly move the phone until the white and the yellow crosses on the screen meet. Good luck!